This is Aileen from Materialise Belgium. In this tutorial video, we'll talk about the 2D part placement tools in Magix. The 2D part placement tools can automatically place parts in a platform for you, so that you can continue by choosing an orientation and generating support where needed. There are two ways of doing 2D placement of parts in Magix. We'll start with the simpler one, and then proceed to the more complex one. First, the Translate tool. Select your part, go to the Tools ribbon, and then click Translate. You can either enter resulting coordinates and click on Apply, or you can enter relative translation and click on Apply. Alternatively, you can use the interactive translation tools. The red, green, and blue arrows move your part along the X, Y, and Z axis, respectively. You can also use the To Default Position and To Default Z buttons to quickly place a part on these locations. The Default Position and Default Z position can be changed from Machine Properties, Parts Placement. If you're working with one or very few parts, this function can be sufficient. But as the number of parts increase, it can get tedious to place them on your scene. Then, you can use the Automatic Placement tool. With Automatic Placement, all your parts can be placed on your platform with a single click. Let's select our parts, go to the Build Preparation or Position ribbon, and click on Automatic Placement. Part interval is the distance between your parts, and platform margin is the distance between the edge of your platform and the parts. You can choose to place all parts or only those selected. You can translate all parts to default Z height or keep the original Z height. The second option could be interesting if you are working with parts that already have supports on them. If you have too many parts to fit into a platform, you can enable multi-platform placement. Once your first platform is full, a new copy of your platform will be created, and the rest of the parts will be placed in the new platform. For the placement, you can use different algorithms. Bounding box will take the bounding boxes of the parts into account, and geometry will consider the original shape of a part. Once you have decided on the algorithm, you can choose to stop at the first solution, or when the minimal surface area, X dimension or Y dimension is reached. Alternatively, you can place the part in the center of your platform. Moreover, you can set the automatic placement tool to only translate or translate and rotate your parts with degree intervals that you can specify. Let's click on OK and automatically place our parts. After automatic placement, you can either use the result as is, or you can always use the translate option to fine-tune the part placement. Thank you for watching, and please make sure you check our other tutorial videos. For further questions about our software, please don't hesitate to contact the support line of your nearest Materialise office.